हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सेम फोर, सुभाष चंद्र बोस, इट मीन्स एस सी बोस, वो गेव अ स्पीच व्हेन ही रीच्ड एट द जर्मनी. व्हाट ही टोल्ड टू हिज पीपल, व्हाट ही वॉन्ट टू से टू हिज पेट्रोइस्ट वो आर इन देयर कंट्री, वो आर इन हिज कंट्री, दैट वी विल सी into this story. First of all, I want to explain you that, I want to tell you that if we make a list of our patriot, our freedom fighter, the one name always come into our mind is Gandhiji. Yes, of course, he played a vital role to give us freedom. But is he only give us freedom? No. With him, many more freedom fighters are there who played also a very significant role to give us freedom, to give us how we live today. Actually, they are not giving us only freedom, but they give us that how to live with our liberty. Actually, there is a difference between the freedom and liberty, as you know that. Independence and freedom, there is also a difference between that. Except Gandhiji, the freedom fighters like Bhagat Singh, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, and yes, of course, none of them, the Subhas Chandra Bose, taught us how to live in freedom, how to live in independency. They taught us a very likable play. He taught us that how to live with our dignity. That is also called a self-respect. Yes. Subhas Chandra Bose gave a speech in Germany, and what he told to us that we will see into this video. Subhas Chandra Bose was born 1897. Remind that he was born in 1897. And he was dead in 1945. Was one of the freedom fighters of India. If we make a list like Bhagat Singh, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, of course Subhas Chandra Bose, and many more freedom fighters, one of them is Subhas Chandra Bose. He was also known as Netaji. Actually, his pet name, his given name, was Netaji. Everybody known him by the Netaji Subhas Chandra Bose. He became the president of Indian National Congress from 1938 to 1939. President of Congress after actually that time Congress was the only party who ruled over the country, and he became the president of the party for a year, 1938 to 1939, before our independence. He showed help from the Nazi forces and Imperial Japan in the war against the British. He tried a lot to free India, and that's why he also gave a company to Nazi force and Imperial Japan. He reached at the Japan and war against the British. There was a war between the between Britishers and Indian. At that time he reached the British. He is supposed to have died in a plane crash in Taiwan in 1945, before independence, because our independence we got into 1947, and it is said that it was not sure. Actually, his death is not sure because nobody got his body after his death. It is said that when he reached to Taiwan in a plane, and at that time his plane was crashed and he was dead. But it was not sure, it was not fixed. अबाउट हिज स्पीच व्हाट ही वांट टू टेल अस. ही फॉर्म्ड आजाद हिंद फौज एंड गेव अ स्लोगन चलो दिल्ली बिकॉज एट दिल्ली ही वॉन्टेड टू गैदर्ड ऑल द पीपल एंड ट्राई टू एक्सप्लेन हिम अबाउट द इंडिपेंडेंसी अबाउट द फ्रीडम एंड द कंट्री. सो ही गेव अ स्लोगन टू आजाद हिंद फौज. आजाद हिंद फौज वॉज अ पार्टी एट दैट टाइम विच वॉज फॉर्म्ड बाय हिम विच वॉज फाउंडेड बाय हिम एंड ही गेव अ स्लोगन टू द पीपल टू दैट चलो दिल्ली. He is supposed to have died in a plane crash in Taiwan in 1945. The speech of Subhas Chandra Bose is directly addressed to the soldier who had signed up to be the fight against the British forces for the freedom of India. This is a speech which was given by Subhas Chandra Bose and which was directly addressed to the soldiers who are served for the country, who are connected to give freedom to the country. He directly addressed to them. British forces to freedom of India, when, as you know that when the Britishers arrived in India and our freedom fighters try to fight with them to go back. At that time, he addresses to our soldiers and try to motivate him, try to encourage him. And that's why he gave a speech on that. He lays down the importance of fight for freedom and hardship the soldiers will have to face. He promises freedom and independency as long as the soldiers are ready to give their life for the motherland. He brilliantly rouses the nationalistic pride and the soldiers with his word. At that time, he brilliantly rouses the nationalistic pride. It means the pride for the nation. Nationalistic is an adjective here, which noun was national. Nationalistic pride, proud pride of the soldiers with his word. Actually, he gave proud to the soldiers that you are very fortunate that you have to give something for your country. You are trying to give something for your country and it is your pride at which this kind of words he want to motivate. Sorry. He want to motivate the soldiers and that's why he told that it is your national pride that you have to contribute it for your country. Let's start the speech, what he want to tell to the soldier. Brave soldiers, bravo, when we want to greet someone, we speak that word, bravo. So he started his speech with the word bravo, brave. What a nice word, na? Generally we see that the speech started with honorable, respected. But he directly motivated to soldier and said that bravo, brave. Today, you have taken an oath that you will give fight the enemy till the last breath of your life under the national tricolor. At that time, our tricolor, which was tricolor, it means our flag, which was made by Madam Kama, There was no Ashok Chakra in that, but there was a flower in that tricolor. And he started his speech to tell them that you have already taken an oath. Oath, it means vow, pratigna, pledge also. The similar word of that. As you know that when a person gets degree of police, doctor, teacher even, they take an oath that I will do my best, I will do my level best, I will serve for my country, I will not corrupt. At that kind of vow they are taken when they get the degree. It's the same way when the soldier becomes soldier. It means the training was over. At that time they are taking an oath that you will give fight the enemy till the last breath of your life. Under the national tricolor is in Indian ritual, as we know that the oath will be taken with the fire, with the water, and they take an oath that I will take an oath that I will not do that, I will take an oath that I will not do that. That kind of oaths are taken into Indian culture as per Indian rituals. But Subhash Chandra Bose told to soldiers that you took an oath under the tricolor. It means you have to respect it. You must be respected by it. Because nothing is best, nothing is greatest than your sacrifices. From today, you are the soldier of Indian National Army of Free India. You are becoming soldiers. It means you get a label, you get a degree that from now you are an Indian soldier. So it is a very proud moment for you also. You have volunteered to soldier the responsibility of 40 crores of Indians. From today, your mind, might and money belong to Indian National Friends. You have the honor to be pioneer of soldiers, Azad Hind Fauj. From today, your mind, might and money belong to Indian National Friends. As we told that, tan, man, dhan thi seva aapvi. Not only by the physical, but also with the economical, with also the mentally stability that is served for the country. So from today, your mind, might and money belong to Indian National Friends. It means all of yours, your body, your economy, your famousness, everything is for the country now, will be becoming for the country now. Friends, you have the honor to be pioneer of soldiers of Azad Hind Fauj, the first party that was becoming at that time for the soldier. And the name of the party was Azad Hind Fauj, as I told you. And you have to be proud that you are becoming soldiers of that party. Your names will be written in golden letters in the history of free India. As you know that your names will be written into golden letters of free India because you are the first batch of soldiers who are becoming a part of Azad Hind Fauj as well as the part of to be free India. Your names will be written in golden letters of history of free India. Every soldier who is martyred in the holy war will have a monument in free India. As we know that every soldier who is martyred, it means who is becoming Shaheed at that time. In this holy war, there is two kind of holy word. We called in Gujarati Pavitra Holi, a festival. holy war, it means the war is also considered as the holy, because this war is for something good. This war is for the betterment of people. That's why he used a word holy war. You have to honor the pioneer soldier of Azad Hind Force. Your names will be written in golden letters in the history of free India. Every soldier who is martyred in the holy war will have a monument in free India. Monument, smarak. As we know that, like a Taj Mahal is a monument for the Shahjahan, for the Mumtaz, Shahjahan made for the Mumtaz, and that's why it is a monument. It's the same way, the place where the soldiers are, where the soldier's body was buried, that will become the monument in free India. When the India become free, the place where the soldiers are died, the place is become also the monument for them. You are very fortunate that you have to got this valuable opportunity to serve your motherland. And as well as he also told them that you are very fortunate, it means lucky. You are very fortunate that you get a chance to serve for your country, for your motherland. Although we are performing this ceremony in a foreign land, actually we are not in our land, we are performing this ceremony into the foreign land, into the another land. Our heads and hearts are in our country. What is there if our body is at another place, but our soul, our mind is at our place only? Can you say me that, what is the difference whether a mother is into the South America, mother is into the New York or Switzerland, but his soul always connected with his child? It's the same way the soldiers are into another country, but their mind, their soul, their body are connected with their motherland. It's the same way Subhash Chandra Bose wanted to tell the soldiers that though what is happened, what is, however you are in the another country, but your soul are connected with your country, so be freedom, get a freedom, be brave. You should remember that your military and political responsibilities are increasing day by day, and you must be ready to soldier them completely. It means your military services, you are now becoming a part of military service, army soldier, and that's why your military services and political responsibilities also, because the political person pressurized you, the political person told you that do like that, are increasing day by day. And you must be ready to soldier them completely. And you have to take this responsibility on your soldiers. And our soldiers take it. Soldiers take these responsibilities on their shoulder. What a line. As you know that in our today's days, what is the pandemic situation going on, the COVID-19. How the soldiers take the whole country's situation, world country's responsibilities on their shoulder. Really salute to them, huh? Okay, then we go ahead. The drum of India, independence, has been sounded. As you know that, a king honed, and when he actually a king, when he wanted to started his kingdomship, at that time he play a horn and then the person come and then the procedure started. At the same way the drum is started to play, it means the procedure is started to get India free, has becoming sounded. The drum is already started to play, now get work, get awake and started to get free our India, our independence. We have to prepare for the battle ahead. वी शुड प्रिपेयर अवर सेल्व्स एज अर्ली एज पॉसिबल सो दैट वी कैन परफॉर्म द ड्यूटीज वी हैव शोल्डर्ड. वी हैव टू परफॉर्म द ड्यूटीज दैट आर ऑन अवर शोल्डर्स. एंड वॉट आर द ड्यूटीज ऑन अवर शोल्डर्स? टू गेट इंडिया फ्री. दैट इज अवर ड्यूटी विच वॉज ऑन द शोल्डर ऑफ सोल्जर्स. आई अश्योर यू दैट द टाइम इज नॉट फार when you will have to put to use the military skill which you possess. The time is not far that the training you already taken into your training time, into your training situations, how to fire, how to give defeat to your enemy. All the training that you take in your during your training time, you have to apply in your real time. Now it is a time to show your training, how much training you get from your training camp. It is a time to show them. Today, we are taking the vow of independence under the national flag. A time will come when you will salute this flag in the Red Fort. Actually, Red Fort was the only place at that time which was considered as the national level building. And that's why, as you know, that on the 15th August and 26th January, our flag was first hoisted into Red Fort, and then after we hoisted our flag. So, as you, Subhas Chandra Bose said that a time will come when you salute this flag into the Red Fort, our building, because the others building was built by the Britishers, by the British Empire, but the Red Fort was the only building which was at that time built by the Indian. And that's why we want to hoisted the flag, our independence flag, into the Red Fort. But remember that you will have to pay the price of freedom. Freedom can never be had by begging. We cannot get freedom by begging. Please give freedom. Allah ke naam pe de de freedom. It is not possible. Bhagwan ke naam pe de de freedom. It is not possible. Freedom has to be snatched by ourselves only. We cannot beg it. We cannot plead it. We cannot request it for freedom. We have to snatch it. We have to fight for it. We have to take it by ourselves only, whether it is independency, whether it is freedom. Remind that. The time will come when you salute the flag on the Red Fort, but remember that you will have to pay the price of the freedom. Freedom can never be had by begging. It has to be got by force. As I told you that you have to snatch it, you have to take it. Its price is blood. And what is the price to snatch it? Our blood. We have to flow it for our country, for our motherland, for our next generation. We will not beg freedom from any foreign country. We shall achieve freedom by paying its price. And what is the price? Our blood, our body, our soul. It does not matter how much price we have to pay for it. It doesn't matter that what is the price for it. If the only child was martyred into this war, it is does not matter. As you know that Bhagat Singh, Lal Bahadur Shastri, all are got martyred themselves at that time when we got freedom. And they did not look back single time to not go out there. They just go out and hang themselves to get freedom only. It is the price. It is the biggest price that India was paid to get freedom. I assure you that as I lead the army where we march to India together, the news of ceremony that we are performing here has reached India. It will encourage the patriots at home who are fighting empty-handed against the British. Throughout my life, it was my ambition to equip in an army that will capture freedom from the enemy. I assure you that I shall lead the army where we march to India together. We have to work together. We cannot separate ourselves from each other. So we have to work on leadership. The news of the ceremony we are performing here has reached India. The ceremony that was already performed into another country, but the news already reached at the India that the soldiers are taking an oath. It will encourage the patriots at home. The person who are not connected with that army, who are not connected with the soldiers, who are also awake by this speech, who are also awake by this news, who are fighting empty-handed against the British, who has no tool to fight with the Britishers, who are also awake at that time. Throughout my life, it was my ambition to occupy an army that will capture freedom from the enemy. I want to build a system that in this system a person captured by an enemy. Today, I congratulate you because the honor of such an army belongs to you. I congratulate you because the honor of such an army belongs to you. With this, I close my speech. Whatever I want to tell you, that I already told you. Now I completed my speech. May God be with you and give you strength to fulfill the pledge which was taken voluntarily today, as a voluntary today. Inqilab Zindabad. Jai Hind. So here we completed the speech of Subhash Chandra Bose. Now we go ahead about the second chapter into our next video. Till then, remind the speech that Inqilab Zindabad. In today's situation, as we know that we have to fight with, not for the Britishers, but ourselves. We have to save, we have to keep ourselves in a safety, not only for us, but for the, our family also. So, I hope you will also fight with these pandemic situations and take yourself safe and healthy. Have a nice day.